WWE 2K22 just released their brand new footage and a brand new trailer, and we got to see a hell lot of things. Unfortunately, the game is coming out on March 2022, and we will get to know more about the game by January. Looks like we are not gonna get any other news, but for the time being, we can actually break this trailer down, and that is exactly what I'm here to do. So the first things first, we can see that we have a brand new SmackDown stage. Now this is very, very similar to the Thunderdome stage that they did once upon a time. So yes, they're basically utilizing the Thunderdome arena, which actually looks not that bad because there is audience, which is really great. Then if we move forward, we got to see Rey Mysterio. Now this time Rey Mysterio looks a little bit different. Last time we saw him, he had no t-shirt. Looks like now he has a t-shirt. Images that has been added on that attire of his. So that looks pretty nice. We also get to see Sheamus doing his move right there. Now this is done, I believe, from the video editor. So that's why it's so blurred in the background. So I'm not sure if this is how exactly the thing is going to be. But if that's the case, if it gets this blurry in the background, then it's great. Now if we move along again, we got to see Rey Mysterio one more time doing his signature entrance. Now it looks like his entrance has changed again. So that's pretty nice. New entrances from the looks of it. Then we have Ricochet. He looks new. He looks good. He has a new ring attire and looks like he's going to have a brand new entrance from the look of this right here, which I always wanted him to have a new entrance. So it looks like he's going to get that right there. Then we also get to see Bayley with a new, of course, new model, new facial texture, new hair, everything. The heel character is there, and we can also see Carmella over there with that new character that she brought in. So that looks all nice and great. Then we got Finn Balor, and from the looks of it, again, Finn Balor also changed, new model and a brand new entrance for the Prince right there. So that looks really nice, and the camera angles, at least from here, looks pretty good. But then again, we don't know if it's done from video editor or that is how the entrance camera angles would be. Then we also got Roman Reigns, and obviously Roman Reigns had to be changed head of the table right now. He has much larger beard. We got The Miz. He has a new brand new entrance with a brand new attire and all that stuff. Rhea Ripley is right here once again. Of course, I believe that she must be having a new entrance as well. Shinsuke Nakamura, from the looks of it, is going to have the same entrance, but I guess the lighting is different. But then again, you cannot say, because I don't know if this is how the light is going to look like. Looks like they have added like these flares that you see. I believe they have added, you know, separately. I believe this is a video editing thing that they have done for the trailer itself. And then if we move forward, we get to see more Roman Reigns without his shirt. So this is like his new thing that when he became heel, this is how it looked like. So of course, that looks nice, but I don't know where this is. Looks like this is near the entrance. So I don't know what this is exactly, but well, we'll get to see what that will be. I think that's just some the taunting and all that stuff. Then we got to see Kane once again. Looks like they're going to be reusing his model. He looks a little bit different somehow, but of course, it's going to be the reuse of the same model. The moveset of the chokeslam looks exactly the same, so there's no difference. There's Shelton Benjamin there. We also have a brand new Raw stage. Again, similar to Thunderdome, from the looks of it, you can see some of the, you know, bars at the top. That is apparently from the Thunderdome, so that looks pretty nice. I apparently cannot say Thunderdome, which is really good. And then we get to see Goldberg. His face looks very funny to me, so I don't know what is happening to his face, but that's fine. We get to see Dolph Ziggler after that as well. He has a new band, a new hair, the blonde hair that he comes out with. I believe he must be having a new entrance, but well, we cannot say about that. Again, I'm 100% sure that Goldberg, nothing has changed, except probably a better model. And then we have Bobby Lashley. Looks like he has either a better model or just like the same model being reused. I think Kofi Kingston might have new tattoos. He has a new hair and all that stuff. So I think Kofi Kingston's from the face doesn't look that much different, but I think he might have changed a little bit, just updating a little bit. And then we have Drew McIntyre with a brand new attire. Of course, he has that sword and he has a new entrance. From the looks of it, his hair is also different. And we also have this pyros and all that stuff. So again, it's a Thunderdome era, so that's what's happening right here. And that's basically all it is to see. So overall, the gist of this whole trailer is where they wanted to showcase how amazing the game looks, the graphics, the visual, the models. We have new entrances. So that is one thing that they have shown in this trailer completely. All of these superstars that we see have brand new entrances at least, or maybe some new movesets here and there. So that is pretty good. Again, the game looks really nice. I hope that the camera angles is something that this game is showing, but then again, I believe that this is a trailer, so they must have made it in a video editor inside of the game, you know, how you can change camera angles and all that stuff. So I believe that is how this is made. Of course, new attires and new looks is really good, but then again, at the very end of the day, we need to know how the game runs, how the game plays, how is the gameplay, how does that feel, are there any improvements from the previous game, you know, AI, whatever, everything else that everybody wants, is that in the game or no? Now, it was quite obvious that the visuals would be much better because we already saw a screenshot of Edge from WWE 2K22 before SummerSlam hits. But then again, we always have to wait until the next news come along, which is going to be on January. So it's a long time for the wait, but I hope that it is worth the wait. Unless there are some rumors and leaks about the game that will come out beforehand. And if that happens, you can watch all of that in this channel right here by subscribing it right now. And by the way, did you know that there are 5 big improvements that WWE 2K22 literally needs right now? Well, check that video out right after this.